Hello everybody, Nate Brown here, and happy 2019 National Customer Service Week. I've been very excited for this week. I know you have been as well. How cool that customer support has its own holiday. I think it's well deserved and it's just awesome. So enjoy the heck out of this week. I have a few thoughts rolling around in my brain, as usual. I'm hoping to be able to encourage you with some of those this week, and I've got some of my Packers gear on here, and it's got me thinking about how customer support, as the Effortless Experience would put it, really is that defensive line for the brand, for the organization. And you cannot win the game of customer experience without a strong defense. There's always going to be things going wrong, problems with mismatched expectations and different things. And the customer support environment is there to stand in the gap between what would cause significant damage to that brand to actually generating an even more loyal customer. I mean, that's the power that we have when we facilitate a great resolution. We actually create an even more loyal customer than if they had never had an issue. So a tremendous competitive advantage for those organizations that value customer support and have people like you that are doing this work. So I've got two thoughts in particular that I wanted to extend to you this week. The first is around change management. As I do customer support and do customer experience work more and more, I see that the ability to generate lasting and meaningful change is so much this work. And if we have the ability to speak fluently the change management language inside of our organization, we are far better equipped to make some great things happen on behalf of our customers. I'm a huge advocate for Lean and Six Sigma. And when we think about Lean, I mean, it's really eliminating waste to put maximum value to the customer. And when we do a great job curating knowledge and saving each other time in areas like knowledge curation and great tools that enable instead of frustrate and just eliminating that waste that is so often there, we have the ability and the freedom to serve our customers much better. So become fluent in that language inside of your organization as far as change management. And if there's not one, become fluent in Lean, because I think that's just a great one to pick. And thought number two for you is that customer experience really starts with the cubicle next door. I mean, we know more and more how customer experience work has that foundation of the employee experience. And I think we're all shocked to see how real and how palpable that connection really is. I mean, we can only take the experience that we have and mirror it to our customers. And what we often undervalue is how much power we actually have over our peers in terms of the experience that we are creating. Tiny Pulse has some great data that the number one reason that people love their jobs is when they have a great network around them of colleagues and peers that they can depend on. I mean, it has such a tangible effect on your ability to come to work, to be engaged and be happy, and to serve customers well. When you relate to the people around you, when they trust you, when you trust them, and you can do the work together, it makes a tremendous difference. So I would encourage you with that. I mean, as far as serving customers really well, it starts by serving those around you really well and finding ways to make the best experience possible for them so that you can together make the best experience possible for your customers. So happy National Customer Service Week, and I will see you later.